This is so trippy. I could stare at this lava lamp for hours. Wake up, Kamri. What exactly is a lava lamp? Is this even lava? And how does the lamp create such mesmerizing floating globs? To shed some light on this lamp, I brought on the help of an expert. There she is now.
Whoa, Ruby loft far out.
Thanks. Are you my expert?
Yeah, I'm Asha Jay, a National Geographic explorer and a creative conservationist who knows her lava lamps. They're beautiful examples of how science blends with creativity. Now let's see your lamps. Hypnotic, aren't they?
Yeah. So, first question, am I actually looking at lava?
Nope. Lava is just a marketing name corporations give it. You're looking at two substances floating in harmony.
How exactly do they float in harmony?
To build a true lava lamp, your substances need to have different densities.
So one substance will sink to the bottom.
The other, and this is my favorite, immiscibility.
What's immiscibility?
It's a fancy science term meaning unmixable. The two substances in a lava lamp are typically water-based liquid and a waxy compound. They can never dissolve into each other. You can see it at home when you combine oil and vinegar. They never truly blend into each other.
Yet they taste great on a sandwich. All right, I see how two immiscible substances form the blobs in the lamp, but how do they rise up and down?
That comes from the power of your lamp's magic light bulb.
Magic light bulb?
Okay, it's a normal light bulb, but the heat from the bulb brings the magic. The heat causes the blobs of wax to rise. As they get further away from the bulb, they cool. Then they fall back down to the bulb, and the cycle begins all over again.
Why does the heat cause them to rise?
For that, we'd have to view the blobs on a molecular level. And there's no way we could possibly...
We could use my molecular shrink ray.
Yeah, we could do that. Honey, let's shrink us kids.
These must be the molecules of the lava lamp's blobs.
As the blob heats up, the molecules spread apart, lowering its density.
And a less dense blob will float towards the top.
Exactly. Now watch. See how the blob cools off? The molecules pack closer together? It's making the blob more dense.
It's amazing to look at a lava lamp from inside its own molecules.
Yes. Can we go home now? Kamri. Kamri. Kamri!
Now that you know how that works, catch up on all the other episodes of How Things Work by clicking right here. And also make sure you subscribe to Nat Geo Kids by clicking down here. See you next time. Bye.